everybody. I'm Jeff Foxworthy, and welcome to the show that gives grown-ups the chance to prove that they are actually smarter than a fifth grader. All right, let's meet tonight's classmates. He is a 40-year-old host of The Tonight Show who attended St. Mary of the Snow Elementary School. Please welcome Jimmy Fallon.
Welcome to the show, Jim. Yeah.
Welcome to your show.
And he will be competing against a 34-year-old multi-platinum recording artist. Please welcome Pitbull. That's awesome. Welcome. That's beautiful. All right, and we have got a couple of real smart fifth graders from the show joining you guys tonight. On Team Jimmy, we've got Trace, and on Team Pitbull, we've got Angela. Come on out, guys.
Action, speak louder.
So, we had a few Red Bulls back then.
So, Jimmy, when you were in the fifth grade, what kind of student were you?
I swam around the seas.
Pitbull, what about you in school? What kind of student?
In fifth grade?
Yeah.
I was already touring schools in fifth grade.
All right, well, let me tell you how the Tonight Show, Are You Smarter Than a Fifth Grader, works.
Okay.
I'm going to show you guys 10 subjects. They range from first grade through the fifth grade, okay? Mm-hmm. You can answer them in any order you like, but you should know this, that the point totals correspond to the grade. And the final round, I've got one sixth grade question, which will be worth 10 points, okay?
All right, good.
That's up to Jimmy and Pitbull to answer the questions. But if you aren't sure about the answer, at one point during the game, we're going to give you a cheat. You can cheat off of your classmate there. That means you can ask them for help. We got it?
Here we go.
All right, Jimmy, you're up first. Which category would you like?
Well, first grade's looking real good.
Get some of the big ones in there first to knock them out first.
Yeah, I guess you could do that. Let's go fourth grade. Grammar.
Fourth grade grammar.
Yeah.
When you know the answer, I want you to lock in at your buzzers, okay?
Okay.
All right, let's see the fourth grade grammar question. In the sentence, Questlove is a very good drummer, what part of the sentence is the word very? I'm sorry, in the sentence, Questlove is a very good drummer. What part of speech is the word very?
He means the fifth grader. He means the fifth grader. Yeah.
You're not even going to check for help on this. You think you know this.
I'm sorry, speech is very. Very is, if he's
talk
very...
Talk this out, because I'd really like to hear it.
Well, I would... Well, I'd say you're describing how well he is at drumming, so I would say, maybe, is it an adjective?
Are you asking me, or...
how does this work? No, but if he's a very good drummer, he's very good... All right, he's giving me these cool eyeballs, which means don't go for it. We should maybe talk?
Yeah.
All right, wait. Let's talk for a little bit here.
So you're using your cheat. I want to establish this on the first question.
Don't call him a cheat already. He's a nice kid.
Yeah, he's using his cheat.
He's using the very cheat at this point.
Yeah. Very. So Questlove is a very good drummer.
Yeah.
It's not an adjective.
No.
It's not a verb, but it's an adverb.
Yeah.
It's an adverb.
Right, very good, yeah.
You're gonna lock that in? You're locking in adverb?
It was great having you on the show, man. Take care. Good luck with everything. Get out!
So you're locking in adverb?
Yeah, we're gonna lock in adverb.
Lock in adverb.
Yeah.
So you said adjective. If you had only said adjective, you would have been 100% incorrect. Trace is right. It's adverb. You got 4 points. Very nice job. All right, Pitbull. You are up next. What category would you like?
Okay.
Let's get a lot of points.
Angie says we gotta go with fifth grade.
Chemistry.
Fifth grade chemistry.
Fifth grade chemistry.
By
But I'm thinking,
I'm okay.
World
I'm okay.
You know, Mr. Worldwide, Angie.
Yeah. Did you just astronomy? Did you do astronomy? I have a good feeling.
I'm rolling with you. What do you want to do?
I feel like astronomy.
Astronomy.
I have a good feeling.
Okay.
I have a really good feeling about it.
Okay, hey.
You're the adult here, so, I mean, at any point...
We're going with astronomy.
The second grade astronomy. Correct answer's worth 2 points. Here is the second grade question. In our solar system, which planet is farthest from the sun? In our solar system, which planet is farthest from the sun?
Just for comedy's sake, can you say Uranus?
Come on!
Yeah,
The fifth grader's loud.
Yeah.
Yeah, you guys like, that was good. I had to say it.
Well, yeah, but they laugh if you put your arm like that and go like that.
I was going to do that next.
Yeah.
All right.
You think you know this without a cheat, Pitbull?
No, I definitely got to cheat on this. So,
second grade question.
Okay.
Yeah, it's
Neptune. All right. So, she told me, she said it's like...
Not like anything. It's
I got you. Okay. But I'm trying to put it together, give you a little riddle since you want to ask all these questions. It's like Pharrell's production group in the late 90s. Yeah, going in the early 2000s. You know who Pharrell is? I didn't think so. So, it's Neptune.
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 Let's do it.
Actually, Neptune is absolutely right for 2 points. All right, we're almost out of time, which means it is time for the final sixth grade question. Remember, it is worth 10 points, so whoever answers this correct wins the game. For this last question, each team can work together to come up with their answer. Whoever is the closest to the right answer wins.
Agent, by the way.
Let's take a look at the question.
Okay.
In miles, how far is the Earth from the sun right now?
Yeah.
In miles, how far is the Earth from the sun right now?
Like
40
something.
20,000.
40,000. Like, no, not 40. That's too
big. I don't have any idea.
What? 4,000.
Okay. Jimmy, do y'all have an answer?
We're going to say 20,000 miles.
You want to lock that in? 20,000 miles. It's like a warranty on a Chevrolet or something.
I'm going to lock it in.
He's locking in. So, Pitbull, he's locked in 20,000.
Like, that changed your thoughts?
I'm thinking.
You're thinking
about it? Yeah. Thinking if you fly on a plane,
you can't get there on a plane.
By the way, Pitbull could probably get there on a plane.
Yeah. If we fly planes at 37,000, 47,000.
You're talking about feet.
I really didn't want to say that. Yeah.
All right.
Because I'm thinking he's flying 51,000 miles above the Earth.
He might have a Concorde. Yeah. I have no idea. He might own a spaceship. I don't know him that well.
That's why I travel so much in fifth grade.
All right.
All right. So let's do the 20. Let's go 40,000.
Going 40. You're doubling his answer.
Yeah.
All right. For the Tonight Show Are You Smarter Than a Fifth Grader Championship, the correct answer is... 94,071,277 miles. You were so close. So close. Congratulations. Pitbull is the winner. Congratulations. You're smarter than a fifth grader. We're going to be right back with more of The Tonight Show.